Hello and welcome to another Bushwhacker review. Today we are going to be taking a look at Chase Briscoe's Ford from 2018. As always, take a quick look at the box. Got just a generic 2018 box, Roush Fenway Racing, NASCAR Xfinity Series, and Action Racing Collectibles. Down the side, you got a render of the car right there, 2018 Ford Performance, standard finish. Don't think they made any special finishes of these cars. They made a total of 687 of these things, which I'm pretty sure is the full production number between all three of them, like the shared production number, because I don't think they really did make 687 of each driver, but I don't know. But anyways, you got Roush Fenway Racing, NASCAR Xfinity Series. On the back, you got Roush Fenway Racing, Lionel Racing, 2018 Action Racing Collectibles. Of course, you have your copyright and such on the bottom of the box. Sounds like a screw's rolling around at the bottom of that box. Anyways, here is the car itself. The most legendary car in all of NASCAR history, the Roush 60 car. The biggest meme car of the year. And I knew I just had to pick up the diecast of it. Like I said, they produced one for Chase Briscoe, Austin Cindric, and Ty Majeski. But if you're standing there like, which driver should I get? I kind of like this driver more. You're going to want to get this Chase Briscoe one. Why is that? Because this is the only one that's real. Chase Briscoe is the only driver to race this paint scheme this year, this white and gray Ford paint scheme. He raced it only once on the 60 car like this, which was at Atlanta in the spring. And then he's raced this a few times in the 98 Stuart Haas car, like his Roval when he had this paint scheme on the 98 car. Ty Majeski, anytime he's had the Ford, generic Ford 60 car, it's been that black paint scheme they switched to like a quarter of the way through the year. And the only time Austin Cindric has had Ford was literally the throwback that he got wrecked on like lap 2 in. That was a cool throwback. I'd have bought that diecast, but they offered this kind of standard primary gray car, and then they only offered Austin Cindric's blue and white Pertec car. Never offered any of the other ones, but there's some cool paint schemes. They had like a Sunny D car and everything, but somebody finally broke down the, you know, crashes this year, and this car has been involved in incidents in 27 out of 31 races. That's just funny. Shockingly, Ty Majeski's had the most incidents out of everyone. I'm sure that's just, you know, shocking for everyone. But Chase Briscoe is definitely the best driver out of all 360 car drivers. I don't think anyone can really contest that. Ty Majeski is the worst. I'm glad Chase Briscoe was able to, you know, get a ride on a better team and get a win with that better team to kind of prove that he really is talented. But whatever. Let's do a quick 360 of this car. This paint scheme really doesn't make much sense. Like, who was designing a Ford car? I'm like, okay, I need that new Ford Mustang. Let's see, what are Ford's colors? Light gray, red. Like, what are you doing? If you're gonna make a Ford car, it should have, I don't know, some blue. But whatever. That black car looks a little better that they changed to anyways. The real car is matte in real life, so I'm not sure why they made this shiny, but like I said, it's kind of been weird with Roush diecast this year, because most of the cars have been matte finished, but the diecast have been hit or miss if they're matte or not. Really curious to see what happens with this car next year. I mean, generally, Cindric should be like in the 12 full-time for Penske. Then you can put like Chase Briscoe full-time in the 98 for Stuart Haas Racing, and Ty Majeski can have the 60. He's, you know, not like Roush actually looks for talent these days. But anyways, let's get down to sponsors. On the hood, you have one big Ford logo. You got Ford Mustang, number 60 in Roush Fenway Racing. This does have the kind of new light details and everything. That's why they're making the headlights so slanted, though. I feel like they're not really that slanted in real life, but I don't know. Worth pointing out, this has the incorrect kind of Cup Driver Xfinity windshield banner. They gave the Cindric diecast the correct banner, but the other two drivers, they didn't. Not sure why that happened, but whatever. Down the side, you got Ford. In front of the rear wheel, you got Mack Tools, International, and Champion Spark Plugs. Nothing on the C post. And on the B post, you got Ford, Roush Fenway Racing, and Performance Plus Motor Oil. Just has your regular contingencies and such up there. On the back, you got the Ford license plate. You got GT, number 60, Roush Fenway Racing. Does have the rookie stripes. Which everyone kind of forgets that the Austin Cindric Fitzgerald Penske diecast didn't actually put the rookie stripes on that car. But I believe that they did for the 60 cars, so I don't know. But anyways, on the deck lid you got Ford, and on the roof you also have Ford. This is number 75. Got the same stuff down the other side as usual. Let's take a look under the hood. See, it says Ford, Ford Performance, and K&N Air Filters. Was the Ford Performance logo really necessary when you have the Powered by Ford right above it? But I don't know. It's got some like, it's like rough under the hood. That's weird. Anyways, there's the engine detail if you want to see that. Obviously, no trunk and no roof flaps on these Gold Series cars. There's the underside of the car if you want to see that. If you don't buy one of these 60 cars for your collection, you're clearly just not a real collector. This, like I said, this is the most legendary car in all of NASCAR history. The biggest meme car of the year. I knew I just had to pick one up. I would have bought any of the 60 cars they made this year. Roush Fenway Racing is kind of crumbling their Xfinity program because, you know, obviously this car has just been so amazing. And then now Ryan Reed is losing Lily Diabetes. So he's gone because that was the only reason he was there. It's not like he was there because of talent. I wonder if them leaving has anything to do with all that crap around Connor Daly where everyone basically wanted to hurt someone at Lily Diabetes after that whole incident with Connor Daly at Road America. But whatever. It's definitely a pretty nice car. Like I said, the paint scheme really doesn't make sense as far as the colors go, but the design is still pretty nice, and it is really a kind of unique car. This will be a good car to put with, like, Brian Scott's 2016 44 Petty car. That was the biggest meme car up until this one. I'm not sure it's going to become the biggest meme car now, because, you know, if the 60 car leaves, Brian Scott's gone, BK Racing is going to be gone. I guess it'll be, you know, Obikai or however you say that name, that team that's finally going to Cup, even though they've just sucked at Xfinity and now they're sucking in Cup too. But I don't know. Whatever, that's enough ranting for one day. If you want this diecast, it is a brand new release. Like I said, if you want a real, actually raced car, you're going to have to get Chase Briscoe's, not the other two. But I think that's all there is to say. This has been a review of Chase Briscoe's Ford from 2018. Hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching.